I'm Michael Goin. I was an engineering lead at Neural Magic before we got acquired and joined the AI inference team at Red Hat. I'm a committer on the vLLM project, and you know, I just love working on inference optimization. vLLM is a fast, easy to use, open source LLM inference engine. It really comes with a lot of batteries included, but also a lot of generalizability working across and supporting, you know, hundreds of different model architectures, but also several different hardware accelerators, not just NVIDIA, but AMD, Intel, Google, AWS, trying to bring great performance to, you know, whatever hardware accelerator you're working with and trying to scale within your enterprise or your hobbies. A lot of our focus and expertise was on model compression. So one of the things that we really brought to vLLM was quantization and sparsity. So, you know, one of the really, I would say, most important things that we added with respect to quantization is the advent of activation quantization. It's really popular now, and for a while in open source AI, to compress the weights of models through AWQ or GPTQ algorithms or GGUF. While this lets you, you know, fit the model in memory, it doesn't really give you a throughput improvement when you need to serve the model at scale. So what we brought in was quantizing both the weights and the activations. So now you can use those new INT8 and FP8 tensor cores that NVIDIA uses all the time in their spec sheets. And this really brings a benefit not only to the memory usage of the models, but also the, you know, how many tokens per second you can get out of these models. You know, effectively just making it cheaper and easier to serve your workloads at scale. It's important because it's the de facto standard. It's the most well used. It has support for the most amount of models. It has researchers that are constantly contributing to it. It has model providers that are constantly announcing and launching new models on top of it. And it's just a wild ecosystem of growth in the inference optimization space. So we've been working on vLLM for over a year now, and it's been a great project to be a part of and see its growth. Now it has, you know, dozens of different companies, model providers, and academic institutions that contribute to it every day. I think in the last release, we had over 100 unique contributors just within a few weeks of commits. So it's just a very spinning fast flywheel of a project and at the heart of the open source AI movement right now. It's really needed because within open source AI, you need efficient software to host those models. You know, you can use PyTorch or Hugging Face Transformers directly for training or developing your models. But once you actually need to deploy those models and serve millions or billions of tokens in a day, vLLM is built with those inference system optimizations that allow you to fully utilize your hardware accelerators to serve as many tokens as possible for not just text large language models, but also multimodal, embedding, reward modeling, all sorts of different use cases within open source AI. And vLLM just offers the most performant base in open source for hosting these models. I mean, frankly, it's really the generalizability of the project and how many different things it has. So while maybe TensorRT LLM is like really good on NVIDIA because NVIDIA tunes that for themselves, vLLM works on AMD GPUs, Intel GPUs, Google TPUs, AWS Trainium. It has a, you know, a very open core and works very hard to bring the variety of inference algorithms and system optimizations that it implements to a variety of hardware platforms. And of course, models. You can't forget the 100 plus different model architectures that it supports. Because it has that, you know, pure PyTorch base at its core. With respect to what we're going to grow into this year and the following years, I think, you know, we're really excited to see that scale within open source AI, you know, taking people beyond single node or single GPU deployments and really making it accessible for the open source community and enterprise customers that want to self-host their models to scale into that multi-node distributed inference scale where you're talking about, you know, hundreds of GPUs serving one model with disaggregated prefill and decode and all these things you want to look at once you start trying to, you know, really hit those sensitive latency SLOs like time to first token or time per output token as you scale into the billions of tokens a day.